Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a makeup look with the Kylie palette. So if you want to see what I'm going to do with these beautiful colors, just stay tuned. Keep on watching, girl. So I wasn't going to do my brows on camera, but I said I'm just gonna do the whole look and done. So the first thing I'm gonna do is take some wipes and I'm just going to warm my face because I washed my face. This is a different setup. I'm just trying to be more homey, I guess. So it's more comfortable. Welcome to 2018, by the way. 2017 finished so fast that I didn't even realize it was 2018. So let's get into this makeup look. So I'm thinking about doing I want to say like a smoky eye, so I'm going to use the Kylie palette, of course. Just got it for Christmas, so love that. And I'm going to first moisturize my face with this cream. I wonder if you can see that. Yes, this is a cream that I got from the drugstore, and I so let me try it because I like how it smelled. It's on one of my videos. What I have in my makeup bag. So you can go and check that video out if you'd like to see more information on this cream. So it's not too thick. Just right. And I like, this is not a moisturizer per se, but I like how it makes my face feel. So I avoid my eyebrows, by the way. So I just go around the eyebrows. You don't really want too much oil on the eyebrows. Now I'm going to do my eyebrow gel in the color. I'm trying to get it up there. I don't know if you can see that, the color Espresso Brow, and it comes with this little brush. So I'm just gonna use the Kylie palette to get the mirror to do my eyebrows. And if you see me looking now, that's what I'm doing. But I'm wondering if this quality is looking any different because I'm filming with a different camera. So it looks good to me. It looks really nice. So I'm just gonna brush up my brows, girl. And I hope that everyone, you know, gets to do what they needed to do in 2018, what your goals are, and you know, what do you plan to do with your life? And they can see me. So now I'm just filling in the brows. I don't go too deep with the filling because I want to make sure it looks, I don't want it to look natural, as you can see. I don't want it to look too natural, but I just want it to look nice to the fact that I've not overdone it. So let's just get it in there. Ooh. And I'm not going to go to the front, I'm just gonna lift it up like so to the front. But I'm not going to really put any more product on the brush I'm just gonna comb in whatever is there. So I just use this because I don't really have a spoolie right now. So just brush it in. See? It's a little different, but the difference goes a long way. Yes. So I'm just going to do the other one. I'll just pat it out on this thing here so that it wouldn't have too much product on the brush. Let's just get it over with. So I'm just gonna comb it out now. Right, so now I'm gonna clean up my eyebrows with the same brush. This is an angled brush. This is a small angled brush. So I'm just gonna clean out this on a wipes. All right, I said I'm gonna do like a smoky eye, like a New Year's smoky eye type of stuff. But the main palette that I'm using is the Kylie palette, and now I'm taking my concealer, my Pro Concealer in the color Beautiful Bronze. Oh, it's upside down. Beautiful Bronze. So let's just dab the brush in it and let's just go to town. Looks like do the bottom part and then I do the top. And I'm going for the top now. Then I just blend out the ends. And you can do yours anyhow you would like to do your brows. But everybody doesn't have the same method, so what you wanna do is what you wanna do, girl. It's okay if you don't get it the first time, because I didn't. When I used to do my makeup before, I didn't even used to do brows. And it still used to look good. Sometimes I even used to apply my eyeshadows with my finger. And it still came out flawless. Flawless. I made a little mistake, and that is okay. See, it's everybody makes mistakes, not just you who's sitting home watching this. I make mistakes as well, so it looks stupid right now. The when you put on your makeup, it looks stupid in the beginning. So don't think you're doing anything wrong. Everybody makeup looks stupid in the beginning. It looks like you're doing nonsense, to tell you when it's true. But in the end, it's gonna look flawless. So I'm taking back that same brush. I'm taking back some eyebrow gel and just to fix that right there. So let's just... I'm gonna put back some color on it there. Good. See? Good as new. And then we're gonna take... Now we're gonna take our blending sponge. Now I used to use this, but I don't like it really. It's a little too hard for me. It blends nicely, but I'm gonna take one of these wedges. I'm just gonna take my matte setting spray from Shein. I'm just gonna spray it just to dampen it a little bit. You know, some people dampen it with water, but I forgot. So I'm just gonna dampen it with some setting spray. And then just, and you don't even have to blend this out. You can just leave it like that and just cover it with your makeup. But I wanna blend out the ends just a little bit. And of course the center. Just to kind of even it like that. I don't really want too much product on this skin. And it looks like her. So then, I'm going to take some, I'm going to take some primer, pro primer, high definition primer, and it comes out white, so I'm just going to take some and put it on my eyebrows. I could even use this, but see, when I use the camera, I kind of want a closer look, and that's why I use the mirror. So now I'm going to take a flat concealer brush like so, a small one, and I'm just going to blend this out just for it to cover the whole eyeball. You just want to blend it out. Like that. And then I'm going to take this little palette. And I use this as a setting powder. You can see it's almost finished, a cake pan basically. And I'm gonna take my blending brush and just dab it in there to just cover that, because the primer is sticky. And the primer is real sticky. So I don't really want it to be that sticky, because the eyeshadow doesn't blend very well on it. So I want something where it will glide. The eyeshadow could be able to glide on instead of sticking. Now it does hold longer to me without the setting powder, but this is an eyeshadow, so setting powder, eyeshadow, same difference. But it doesn't blend that well. It looks a little patchy to me. So that's why I put a eyeshadow on it. And then now I'm going to take from the Kylie palette. I don't even know. I want a crease color, but what I want to do is my my BH Cosmetics palette, go into that, and I'm gonna take, see, I already hit pan on it though. This brown shade is like a brown clay red kind of shadow, and just pop that in the crease. And trust me, you could see I love this color because it, I've hit pan on it. Oh my god, I swizzled in the wrong color. I swizzled in the wrong thing. I thought I went in the wrong, but I went in pink. This happens all the time. Right, so you swizzle in that brown. Oh, just love this color. And then just pop that in the crease. Like that. And I don't know, maybe I should just let you get a little closer so that you can see what I'm doing. And then you just pop that brown in the crease like that. This is my transition color. I just love it so much. So you just pop that in the crease like that. I do it about twice or three times to get this kind of color. Just something neutral, something natural you want for the crease. So just hit it right there, and I hope everyone had a good Christmas. My Christmas was an ace. I hope yours was too. Hope you enjoyed yourself, not too much though. And then I'm gonna take from the Kylie palette, I'm gonna take this shade, this brown shade, and it's called Crush. Is it? Yes, it's called Crush. So I'm gonna take Crush. I'm just gonna pop that in the crease as well to kind of define that a little more. Hit that there. Boom. And I love this brown shade. Boom. Now, I said I'm gonna do a smokey eye. This is more like a New Year's look. But for somebody who don't like all the blase, it's more of a natural, shiny looking one. And then it still has a little depth to it. So then I'm gonna take 1, 2, 3, 4, peachy, the color peachy. Am I right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Why is it called peachy if it's blue? Oh, am I stupid? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess it's called peachy, but it's not peach though. Whatever. Whatever it's called. So I'm gonna take the blue and just hit it in the crease like that. I'm gonna take one more. And I love this palette because it's so, the colors are so vibrant. Love it though. I really, 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 really do. So there. Hit that in that crease, bro. You need to take the brush with no thing on it, no eyeshadow, and just blend it. Obviously, I'm gonna clean up the eye because it's a little messy right now, but it's gonna work. And as I said, if you're new to makeup and you're doing this and it doesn't look right, you're doing a perfect job. And you see that the color wasn't coming up, and the more you blend, it shows up. So we're just trying to get rid of that. I don't like to use black for the smoky eye. I don't know. It's too dark for me. And then we're gonna take from this little palette again. Should we? Okay. Yes, we're gonna take this purple color here. Just go in with that. Because we want a little depth to it. Just hit it like that. And you just, I do it like twice. So you don't want it too deep. But if you want it deep, 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 you could do it more than a twice. But since we're adding more colors, I'm just going to do everything twice. So you get a nice purpley transition. So hit this again. All this is just to get the depth. And then we're going to do this one more time. There we go. And then I'm going to take this color right here. And that's a dark purple. And I'm just going to blend that in to my crease. So I do my smoky eyes with purples. I don't do with blacks at all. I'm just going to take that color one more time. As I said, we're doing every color twice. I'm just going to get that in there. The lid color is going to be some shiny. Shiny, 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 shiny. It's gonna be really shiny. And then you just hit that. Yes, bitch. Just gonna hit it like so. And then we're gonna take our makeup wipes and we're gonna clean up the sides because it looks. We're gonna clean up the middle, as a matter of fact, because it looks a little disgusting. Let's clean up the front and just bring back. It's gonna bring back that shape, like that oval shape, like your eye. And then we're gonna just clean that up. There we go. And you see, it's nice and deep. It's a nice dark color. I like it. And then we are gonna take now. I'm never gonna do a base though, but I'm gonna take this color. It's a nice golden brown, kind of neutral brown. That's what I'm saying. It's a smoky eye, but it's not too out there. And then we're gonna hit that and just put it on the lid. Ooh, brush. And when you wet your brush, you get the color more rich. Because this is a bronzy type eyeshadow. So I just wet it. And we're just gonna go. Gonna do the other one, and unfortunately I just hit pan on this color as well. This is from the BH Cosmetics palette with the 120 colors. Well, if my lighting changes, because I'm using natural light, so it's about after 4 in the evening. So just going boom, 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 boom. Put that there, and then we're gonna go back in with the dark purple to just define that crease, because you see you got a little messed up there. So we're just gonna go in with that purple to just clean up right by the line, by the crease line. There you are. There we go. I love this eye. Ooh, it looks so different. And then we're gonna take our white and just clean up on the sides again. Just gonna clean up on the front. Moisturizer flow. And now we are going to do the rest of our face, and let's get into it. Let's just do it. Ain't nothing to it but to do it. So I'm gonna take my foundation stick. I would like to use my liquid foundation from Black Opal in the color Mocha Suede. It's this, I like this because when you pump, thing goes up. The pump doesn't really have a straw, just have one little thing like this on the pump. So when you're pumping and it reaches a certain way, it pushes up. Love that. So like you're getting all of the products. So where is my sponge? Okay, so now we're gonna take two pumps for now. One, two, and it's really kind of running. Then I'm gonna take back that setting spray and just spray my sponge. And just we're gonna get into it. Now at first it doesn't really look like your color, but it will blend out so perfect. Oh, so there. I'm just gonna do the bottom half of my face first, and then we're gonna do the top section. So I'm gonna take this Kylie palette again just for the mirror, and we're gonna go in. I know what you're saying. Who gave you this color? But trust me, it gets in there. I feel the sponge is sucking up most of the product. So I'm gonna go back with this blending sponge. I'm just gonna hit it two pumps again because I feel like it's sucking up so much of the product. Sucking up too much. I'm gonna blend this in. it's still wet, it looks like this. Let me cover that, my discoloration on my face. I love it. This blended Ionic. So it's not full coverage, but it's enough if you don't have much stuff on your face. I'm gonna take two more pumps. Oh, one pump as a matter of fact to do my forehead. So far I've used half a pump for the forehead. My edges are not laid, as they say. See how it comes into my skin color? Looks bright on the forehead first. And after blending it and soaking it into the skin, it looks just like your natural color. So, oh, my hand is cramping, bro. So, that is that. Now I'm going to use the concealer. Just have to scrape back the rest of the foundation and the bottle as well. So, you know, it's a little pump. Right. So now I'm gonna take the concealer. Same concealer that I had before, and I'm just going to use it under my eye just to conceal my gap spot. I don't even put much. That's the amount that I do, not too much, and then take that same sponge and go. Just blend that in there. And for the next time. And normally I have the Sasha Abataka setting powder, but that is finished, so I'm going to use my setting powder. So now we're getting there. I'm gonna take my fluffy brush. I'm just going to get my setting powder. And this is the Tobago Tan setting powder. Looks like this. And truly, a little of this goes such a long way. It lasts me so long. I'm just gonna put my under eye, starts to crease up. And this is what I'll be setting the rest of my face with. I'm just setting up my under eye first so that it wouldn't crease up. And then we're going to set the rest of our face. Now we're just going to set our forehead area. Now we're going to do a natural lip with this, but first I'm going to take a next color into my tear duct area. That's the last thing. So I'm just going to do that. I just love this powder. Perfect. Right. And then I'm just gonna take that same blending brush again. And I'm just gonna put this color, this one, in my crease. Just gonna dip a little. It's a very shiny color. Ooh, this is bright though, bro. This is really bright. I didn't expect this to be that bright. That is something. Did not expect that. And so I'm just gonna take a little bit. That's a little bit of powder. Let's put some in there. Right. My god. That looks like ice. But you see the goal is coming up on the lid space. So just gonna take some of the sorbet from Kylie palette and just kind of turn over that, and there we have that. And so now we're gonna do lids. I have this. This is a nice thing. This is from Bangladesh. I don't know what the shade is, but it says number 18 on it. So we're gonna take some of this and put it on our lips. And this goes a long way. A little of this goes a very, very long way. So we're just gonna hit a little bit of this on the lips. And then we're gonna put a nude color over it. Normally I put lip gloss over it, but I'm having a lot of lip gloss today. Just do that. to that other tint. Nothing is at all. It's a little matry. Some of the foundation got on my lip, so it's looking a little stupid. But it's tinted it and nice, so it even looks nice like this. But I'm just gonna take a little bit of this natural lip gloss. I'm just gonna put a little. Like that. See? Natural lips. And there you have it. And then you just take down your hair. I'm not gonna do lashes today. So I'm just gonna, but ooh, girl, you there. Right, and then I'm gonna do mascara from Kylie. So I'm gonna take some of the Kylie mascara and just do my lashes, girl. I love this mascara, girl. It makes me look like I have long lashes. So good. Makes me look like I have lash extensions. So that is that. And then I'm just gonna. And I like how the wand is bendable, so you could get into every nook and cranny that you would like. So there. And then just hit the front. And you could get close to the front, because the front is very thin. It's thin in the front and then thick in the middle. So you could get down in the front. I like that. Because with others, when it's so thick all around, it's so hard to get in the front. There you go. Love these. And then I'm just going to do a little spray spray. And then, girl, we are done. So let's just. This is the part that I hate. I hate this part. Because I never spray right. So let's go. And that, my friend, is the end of this makeup look. And if you like this look, just give it a thumbs up and comment down below what else you want to see from me. And that's going to be the end of my video. I hope you enjoyed it, and happy 2018. And I hope that you achieve everything that you want to achieve in this year. So with that being said, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.